between liter and milliliter. Today, we will learn about the relation between measuring units of liquid, liter and milliliter. Hello, I am Wise Owl. Welcome to the forest. All the animals of the forest come to me for suggestions and advices. Today, I will tell you about the units, liter and milliliters to measure liquids. Hey, you all are panting. From where are you all coming?
We were playing in the forest and we are running from there only. We all are very thirsty. Would you please give us some water?
Yes, sure. You all will get water.
I will drink one drum of water.
I want a bucket of water.
I will drink a big vessel of water.
I want a bowl of water.
Thanks for giving us water. We all were very thirsty.
Friends, I hope all of you have quenched your thirst.
How many kilograms of water did you drink?
Hey, liquids are not measured in kilograms.
Then how?
We measure liquids in liters and milliliters.
What is liters and milliliters?
Liters and milliliters are units used to measure liquids. There are 1000 milliliters in a liter.
1000 milliliter?
Yes.
I drank 1000 milliliter of water.
You have drank more than 5 liters of water. Nearly about 5 liters.
Did I also drank more than a liter of water?
No, Cat Queen. You have drank even less than half a liter of water. Let me explain this to you in some detail. Look carefully at these vessels and fill these blanks according to the given measurement. Kids, you can pause the video to find out the answer.
First, I will tell.
Tell?
Drum. Because it is the largest of all and can carry 200 ml of liquid.
Oh no. Just now sir has told that milliliter is smaller than liters. 1000 milliliters makes 1 liter. So 2000 milliliter is much less than 1 liter.
So, according to you, what will be the right answer?
According to me, a drum has a capacity of 20 liters.
Very good.
Okay, so the capacity of bowl will be 200 ml.
Right. Now you all have got it.
Capacity of bucket is 5 liters.
And capacity of utensil is 2 liters.
Very good, kids.
Sir, please show some more examples.
Look, I have 2 bottles of cold drink and these empty bottles of 1 liter and 100 milliliter. Now you try to pour this cold drink in this empty bottle.
We cannot put 500 ml in a 100 milliliter bottle.
Now try to put this in the empty bottle of 1 liter.
Oh, it became full now.
Yes, so what have we learned from this?
2 500 liters of bottles make a liter.
Yes, right. Means on adding 500 milliliter to 500 milliliter, we get 1000 liters. 500 ml is also known as half a liter.
Sir, can you give some more examples?
Okay. I will recite a story to all of you. Pinky and Bholu live in the village with their parents. Pinky and Bholu got very thirsty while returning from school.
Mom, I'm very thirsty.
Okay, I'll make lemonade for everyone.
We will also help you in making lemonade.
Mother makes 1 liter of lemonade with the help of Bholu and Pinky and fills it in 4 glasses.
Okay, I'll make lemonade for everyone. Now tell me, if I divide 1 liter of lemonade into 4 equal parts, how many quantity of lemonade will everyone get?
400 ml.
No, this is not right. You tell Bholu.
I don't know. Please, you explain, Mom.
How many milliliters are there in a liter?
1000 milliliters.
Correct. Now, if I fill these 2 glasses, then how much lemonade will be left in the jug?
Half the jug is still full.
What is the half of a liter?
Kids, you can pause the video and think about the answer.
This means 2 glasses contains 500 ml of lemonade.
Yes, Mom.
Can you tell how much lemonade is in 1 glass?
Half of 500 ml.
Very good. So what's that?
Kids, you can pause the video and think about the answer.
We have to divide 500 by 2. 250?
Very good, Bholu.
Daddy, we all got 250 ml of lemonade.
Meanwhile, 2 friends of Pinky arrive.
We should give lemonade to our friends too. Why don't we share a part of our lemonade with them?
Look, in total, we have 2 glasses of lemonade.
Then how much lemonade will we all get?
As Mom explained, we have 500 ml of lemonade.
You mean half a liter?
Yes, let's divide 500 by 4.
Kids, you can pause the video and think about the answer.
Look, we all will have 125 ml of lemonade.
Oh, wow, Pinky! You have solved this too quickly.
Today, we have learned about the relation between measuring units of liquid, liter and milliliter. Relation between liter and milliliter. In the last video, we have learned about the relationship between liter and milliliter. In this video, we will learn about how to make 1 liter by combining different units. Do you know? Mixing 500 ml twice gives 1 liter.
Yes, sir.
Are there any other units which on adding gives 1 liter?
Sir, ask a bit more clearly. I couldn't understand.
For example, do you think that glasses of 250 ml can be combined to form 1 liter?
Yes, it can be made. No, I don't think so. 1 liter can be made out of 250 ml.
So, let's see how 250 ml and other units can be combined to form a liter. These 2 glasses have 250 ml of water If both of them combines, how much water will we have?
500 ml water.
Yes, you are right, elephant. If we combine two more glasses of 500 ml water in it, then how much total water will we have?
500 milliliter and 500 milliliter means 1000 milliliter means 1 liter.
Yes, correct. Now see, in one bottle, we have 200 ml of oil and in the other, we have 300 milliliter of oil. Now tell me, to fill a 1000 milliliter bottle or 1 liter bottle, how much oil will you need?
Is the answer 400 ml?
Look carefully. On adding, it gives 500 milliliter. So adding one more 500 milliliter will form 1 liter.
Bholu, your answer is right. Now tell, how many 100 milliliters will add up to 1 liter?
Adding 100 ml up to 10 times makes 1000 milliliter. Means 10 multiplied by 100 milliliter gives 1 liter.
Now, answer one more question of mine. This bottle contains 200 ml of water. How many times 200 milliliter bottles should be added to give 1000 ml of water?
I know that adding 200 milliliter for 5 times give 1000 milliliter or 1 liter. So, if in this bottle, we pour 200 milliliter of water for 4 times, then it will become 1 liter.
Very good, elephant. 5 times will make 1 liter. See this. We have 400 milliliter of milk. We need 1000 milliliter or 1 liter milk. Now look, these are the packets of 200 milliliter, 300 milliliter and 400 milliliter. Which three identical packets will combine to make 1000 milliliter?
Is the answer 300 ml? On combining, I think it will make 1000 ml.
I think the correct answer is 200 milliliter. Mixing three packets of 200 milliliter makes 600 milliliter. And mixing these 600 ml with 400 ml will make 1 liter.
Yes, right. We can see that not only 500 milliliter, but many more units can be combined to form a liter.
Yes, sir. We got it.
So, kids, today we have learned how to make 1 liter by combining different units. Containers for measuring volume of liquids. Today, we will learn how to measure volume of liquids using containers of standard units. Why are you all looking so upset?
Elephant was ordered by his mother to bring 2 liters of milk, but he forgot to bring vessel to fetch it. We all are looking for a right vessel to help the elephant. Can you help us?
Yes, I will definitely help you. But first answer some of my questions.
Yes, ask.
Okay, just look at the nearby shop and tell me what are those things that are found in a bottle.
Bottle of honey, bottle of cold drink, bottle of oil,
bottle of shampoo.
Well done! Can you match all these liquids with their right amount?
Bottle of honey is of 500 ml. Bottle of cold drink is of 200 ml. Bottle of oil is of 5 liters.
Bottle of shampoo is of 1 liter.
Exactly. So we saw that we use liters as units and big containers for liquids which have more volume. And for liquids whose volume is less, we use small containers and smaller units such as milliliter for them.
Okay, so we want a big container for the elephant so that he can fetch 2 liters of milk.
Yes, you got it right.
Could you please explain it more elaborately?
Sure. Look at this example. Chandu brother, how much milk do you want today? I want 4.5 liters of milk today.
Look, Bholu, the milkman has 4 vessels. The largest one is of 1 litre, then 500 ml, then 250 ml, and then the smallest one is of 100 ml.
Brother, which vessel will you use to give 4.5 liters of milk?
I will use 1 liter container for 4 times to measure 4 liters of milk and 500 liters of container to measure the rest 0.5 liter of the milk.
Let me tell you another way. You can also measure 4 liters of milk by using 1 liter of container for 4 times and 250 ml container for 2 times.
Yes, this can also be done. Pinky, bring a container to fetch the milk.
Bholu, which container will be perfect for fetching milk?
I think this jug is perfect to contain all the milk.
This jug wouldn't be able to contain 4.5 liters of milk. This will only contain 2 liters of milk. We shall use a small vessel. Daddy, is the vessel perfect for fetching milk?
Pinky, this vessel is small for containing that much milk. It can only carry 4 liters of milk. Bring a bigger vessel than this.
Bholu, this vessel is also not fit for carrying that much milk.
So, you take this big vessel.
Yes, that would be fine. Is it the right vessel?
Yes, this can carry 4.5 liters of milk. Let me pour milk into this.
Daddy, how much milk have you used for making tea?
Son, I have used 1 liter of milk. Okay, now tell me, if I have used 1 liter of milk out of 4.5 liters of milk, then how much milk is left?
After taking out 1 liter, we are left with 3.5 liters of milk.
Very good, Pinky. Now, could you please bring the cup of tea?
Sure, Daddy. Here is the cup of tea.
If each cup carries 200 milliliter of tea and I have made 10 cups of tea, now can you tell me how much milliliters of tea I have prepared?
2000 milliliter.
200 multiplied by 10 means 2 liter.
Yes, you both are right.
Daddy, how many teacups are sold yet?
I have sold 10 cups till now.
7 cups means how much tea we have sold, Bholu?
If 1 cup contains 200 milliliter of tea, then 7 cups contain 7 multiplied by 200. That is 1400 milliliter of tea. So it means 1 liter and 400 milliliter of tea is sold.
Yes, you are right. Now tell me how much tea is left.
This is quite easy. If we subtract 1400 from 2 liters or 2000 milliliter of tea, we will be left with 600 ml of tea.
So, what have we learnt from this example?
We have learnt how to measure volume of liquids using containers or standard units. Now we can help elephant.
Yes, now I will go and bring a vessel to fetch milk.
Yes, you have made the right decision. Today, we have learnt how to measure volume of liquids using containers of standard units.